Welcome back to KaganTech, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how I use callouts for my object tracking. Basically, the callouts I'm going to be using in this video were callouts that I bought from VideoIVE. I already explained that in my previous video in this series. If you've not seen that, there will be a card on the screen right now so you can go see it. So that's how the callout looks with the object tracking, and now we're basically just going to disable this and start afresh. I'm gonna go pick the callout that I want from my 50 callouts package that I already installed, and it's pretty simple in Final Cut. All you have to do is drag this into your I think it's called a magnetic timeline. Yeah, so you drag it into the magnetic timeline. I'm still trying to find the callout, actually. Okay, there it is. Yeah, so you just drag this and then you retime it to fit, and once you've done that, you're about ready to begin. The next thing you're going to have to do is put the tips where they're supposed to be, like the starting point. Basically, you move the text tip where you want it to be, and then you move the object tip to the object you want to track, essentially. And once you've done that, the next thing you're going to need to do is, well, click the transform button, essentially. When you click transform, then you're almost ready to begin. Now, you just have to click the tracking button on the top left corner. And once you do that, essentially what you have to do is play pause, play pause, play pause, play pause, and keep moving the object tip with the subject that you're trying to track until you get to the end of the effect. You have to keep doing this. Like, Final Cut makes it very easy because you can actually play pause with your space bar. So what I'm doing right now is I'm tapping my space bar to play and pause, and once he moves again, I just move the tracking, the tracking tip, I just move it along with him, and I keep doing that until I get to the end of the effect. Now, when you get to the end of the effect, please do not forget to click done on the top right corner, because if you don't, everything you just did is not gonna stick. So yeah, always remember to click done so that the effects can be saved. And once you're done, make sure you watch the part of the video where you did the effect on over and over again to make sure the tracking is on point. And once you're sure it's on point, then you can continue to other parts of your video editing, but not until you're sure it's done, because sometimes you're going to make mistakes. You can actually go back into that point of the tracking and still fix it. It's not ironclad. It's always something you can correct or fix or move around. Another thing that I like to do to my callouts is animate the tip. Basically, all you have to do is select the callout effect and then come over here on the screen and scroll down to the tip rotation option and lock it in time at the beginning. Basically, you lock it in time, and then you have to now move the cursor to the end, or towards the end, closer to the end, basically. And sometimes you have to zoom a little bit so you can get it right. Yeah, so once you're around the end, you want to come back to the tip rotation and then change the amount of degrees that it rotates, clockwise or anti-clockwise. It really doesn't matter, it depends on the look you're going for. So I'm just going to leave this right there, and let's see how that looks now. Yeah, you see how cool that is? That just makes the effect look way better, way better. So yeah, guys, that's how I use callouts for my object tracking, and I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please leave a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos in this series, please subscribe to see more content. I will be uploading videos to this series very regularly to help you guys edit your videos like I edit my videos, and see you next time on my next video. That should be coming really soon. Peace.